Hello everybody, this is going to be the review of the 128 scale K6 Jungle Speeder MK1K and the Marine Seizure Stronghold ST2M from Acid Rain by the B25 company. I figured I'd do these two together because they're essentially the ones I've already done, but recolored and, well, he's pretty much straight recolor. He is a remold and recolored slightly. So it makes sense just to put them together in one review. So we will look at the speeder first. So it's getting down. So yeah, it's the same thing pretty much. Just different colors, different markings, tamper printing on it. Has the same Gatling gun. So it has the same wheels, which kind of stick on this one. They're a little stickier than the other one. More printing and some paint. And then this guy is pretty much the same, but a new head. Another new head. Nice looking. So the same articulation. Nothing different there. These are basically, the bodies are all the same. They just changed the paint and molding of the plastic. And he has the same gun. Same gun. Which you can clip onto, where the heck was the clip? Onto here, but it doesn't work in this mode. And then you just have to untab the canopy. Get him nestled in there, all snug. And then, of course, you just have to unpeg the back wheels. And then double hinge them out. Bring out the heels. Which lock the wheels. I do like that. And it locks the wheels into place. Don't have them rolling around all willy-nilly. And these ones, these joints are way tighter on this one than the other one I have. The other one's not, like, loose, but it's still way tighter. And then you can put the handgun in here. And there is the ostrich mode, I'm calling it. Yep, and I'll just bring the other one in for a comparison. Because they are, like, the same. They just, have different colors. And you can see the different heads. But yeah, same thing. I think this one might have more paint on it. Or tamper printing as well, I think. So yeah, that's about it. The ball joints here, the top of the legs, the hinge, and that's pretty much it. So it's still pretty cool. I like it. Now the Stronghold here, let's look at the figure, because this guy has a new head and a new gun. It's more of a rifle, holy crap. I was actually more excited for that than I think that guy, just because it's different. They're completely different. So, I do like the head too, I like that nice orange on the helmet. So yeah, same as the other one, different paint, different molded plastic color, but a new gun. Very cool. And now the Stronghold is pretty much the same as the other one. Actually, I'll bring it in so you can see. I mean, the differences are few. This one has the visor on the top, which it moves, but I can't get to it any further than that. And that thing is, it's so close to the helmet, it pretty much negates the opening hatch on this one. So you get a little visory cap thing, but you can't open that up. Unless I'm missing something, but I don't think so. It does have some different tampos, different paint on it. What will be the hands are different. And what's the, but the parts that have weapons on the arms are different. And, that's, I think, all that's different. And they both have the extendable hitches, and now I can show you the way they work, because you have a little, hole in the front of one of them. So now it's a convoy. Tank boy. Whatever. This one, actually, the hatch here, which opens up, is it's tighter than on this one. This is very loose. And this one's much more secure, and it has the same cockpit, pretty much. It has a little ports on the, around it, little hooks. So you can have your men clip onto it there, or peg into it with the feet, like that. It's like, whoa, look at me, mom! Freaking crazy! And then, of course, you can have him sit in there. I like the pistol. It's going to be really hard to have him in there with the rifle. I don't know anywhere to store it. There's no clip that I can find on these bigger ones. Which I really think there would be. But as far as I can tell, there's not. You have a hold of the bars, which I'm not going to have to do right now, because that'll take too much time. So just do that. And, oh, can't open that up. So, eh. Oh well. So, transformation, it's basically the same as before. Well, that was not supposed to happen. Thankfully, they just go back in. They're just ball joints. And same thing over here. Just a, once again, the tabs that have the arms into the legs, not that secure. But the ones that have into the legs into the body are pretty secure. And then they just bring that all the way down. Now you got the feet. Let's get that up. And these are, oh, I forgot to put this thing down. That should be like that. I'll bring those up. that out. The, what would be a hand doesn't really look like a hand anymore. More like a stub. There we go. Now since this was already down, oh, I guess it was easier. Huh. Whatever. And then, same thing. And, there we go. There he is in robot mode. And, you know what, I think I like the tank mode better with this guy, but I think I like the robot mode better with this guy, even though, well, everything apart from the hands, because I really like the articulated fingers on the other one. But in replace of that, they give you these, like, pile drivers, which reminds me of the one robot from Super Robot Wars. He's the red one I mentioned before. And you got him on both arms. Although, I wish they were farther than the hands, because, I don't really know what that's going to do. Like, in a practical sense, anyways. Because they can't go any farther. So, like, literally, tap you. It's going to tap you to death. So, I mean, while they look cool, they don't really function that well. Now, it does have the same articulation. So, the head, ratchet arms. Ratchet arms out. Got an elbow bend. Swivel at the, below the shoulder. Since these are just, like, knuckles now, they do ratchet up and down. Ratchet waist. The legs are ball jointed, as you saw. Swing them forward and back a little bit. They are hindered by the pegs here. They can go out. They can also go forward and backward at the tread, though, so that does help some. Back more than forward. And then the feet flaps can move and side to side. And these can also move a little bit to get out of the way if you want to have it further forward. So he can dance all night long. Now the other thing is, there are ports on here you can utilize for other combinations. Like if you want to sort of things apart, because it does come with the extra connectors, like all the other ones do pretty much. Like, well, most of them do anyways, the bigger ones, I should say. So if you want to start ripping these guys apart, you can start connect them together. Like, let me take the legs here. Get them unpegged. So these guys can actually come away, unpeg from the waist. So just get this all transformed. And, well, it doesn't really work too well here because it's hard. You can't really get in there. I really want to make a centaur though. Actually, maybe. Oh yeah, we can try this. Yeah, we'll do this. This could work. Alright, so I'll pick that in. Oh yeah, this works fine. Okay. So it just has to be up like that. And then just angle the treads, because they have that articulation. Okay, there we go. Figured it out. Alright. So that's neat. Now, well, I still got you. Let's see what else I can do. Rip off the arms. Come on. Yeah, you can come out. Don't bite me. There. Now I'll take these. And, we can put them, well, let's get these transformed first. Yeah, we're going to do something weird here. And we'll peg that in. get those arms out into the space. Into the torso, I think would be a good way to put it. There we go. Okay, I'm liking it. I'm liking it. And same thing over here. Get that flap. And where is... Oh, there it is. Alright, so... Do that. And, okay, I had it like that. And... Connect it. Get in there. Okay. A little bit of... A little bit of modification. Don't want to break anything, though. Alright. Just squeeze it in. Not going to go too crazy, but... There we go. We have a weird abomination mech. It's not too bad, actually. It's a centaur thing. Yeah, I mean, why not? Yeah, so we still got the head left over. It just his mech blew up and he just split. So yeah, that's what you can do with this line. If you can think of other things, you can totally do it. So let me just finish it up here by having a group shot and, well, what's left of the other one. And get out the Laurel. I remembered his name this time. There we go. So, yeah, those were the ones I got. It's a pretty cool line. I really love the fact they give you adapters and stuff to, like, connect and make an abomination like I just did. It's pretty neat. I think they're making bigger ones, too. I'm not 100%, but I wouldn't mind seeing those. This is a neat line. I think so, anyways. So, that is about it, and I'll see you in the next review.